was a young girl, I remember these moments, having my fourth grade textbook and seeing just the shaded parts and wondering, you know, where were the women in these textbooks? Where are the stories about people that were like me? Where are the girls? And as I began to write stories, I was found myself drawn to history, and I found myself drawn to the stories that I hadn't found when I was a young reader. And those are the stories that I've come to write about. When I speak with children in schools, I always tell them that I have another job, that I'm here as an author on my vacation day, and I've always worked full-time. I have a career in philanthropy. I started many years ago at the University of Hawaii, and I'm now Vice President for Advancement at the Pacific Northwest College of Art, which is fun for me because there's an illustration department, so I'll be able to hopefully bring in illustrators and build up that. One of the things I think it's important for children to know about is that if you have a dream and something that you really want to do, you may not always be able to do it full time. We live in a culture that's very celebrity driven, and I think our ideas of success are sometimes like, well, if we can't make it on American Idol, or if we're not a movie star, then we can't be an actor. And I think that's the same way with writing. So for me, I've always balanced those two things. We have two grown children who are still living at home. But I've had a very supportive husband who cooks, which is helpful. And I try to write when I can. I write on weekends, I write at night, and every once in a while I'll take myself away and take a day off and write. My newest book, Abe Lincoln Crosses the Creek, I remember taking a day off from work and sitting at the Oregon State University Library and just pounding away at it. I had 60 books in my desk for years. And I had so much that I decided to also try to do nonfiction for the first time. Shutting Out the Sky, Life in the Tenements of New York was that book. And it follows the immigrant experience from 1880 to 1924, when people came over from Eastern Europe and Italy. And then it talks about what life was like on the Lower East Side. It's been very interesting for me to use that book in classrooms with children, and also to have them look critically at the photographs. That's one of the things that I've been doing with kids a lot, is have them get a sense of history by looking at the photographs and seeing what they might be able to tell. I was recently in Lowell, Massachusetts, where I was born and grew up, and my second nonfiction, longer book is called Up Before Daybreak, Cotton and People in America. And there you can actually see in the Lowell Historical National Park what a mill was like. So those books tie together in a way of looking at aspects of our history that were very much important to children. Children were involved in the fields as enslaved workers, as sharecropping kids after the Civil War, in mill workers. And I think that's a way into history for kids, is to see that what their lives might be like if they lived in a different time.
Funding for AdLit.org is provided by the Ann B. and Thomas L. Friedman Family Foundation. For more information on adolescent literacy, please visit us online at www.adlit.org.